Hello Techies, this is Miguelina Betty, aka Catwoman from Tech Valor. For this video, I will show you why and how I changed the firmware on my husband's Note 10 Plus. I will list the timestamps below so you can fast forward to the tutorial. Why I changed the firmware. Mr. Catwoman wanted the Aura Blue Note 10 Plus and decided to take advantage of the deal that Samsung had to offer by trading in his S10 Plus. The unlocked version of Samsung phones used to be the creme de la creme, but not anymore. If you want the best connectivity and to be first in line for Android updates, it's best to add the carrier firmware to your unlocked phone. Keep in mind that following these steps will delete all of the data off of your phone, so back it up using Samsung Smart Switch. Materials you will need: your Note 10, a Windows PC, USB Type-C cable, and OTG adapter. Files you will need. I will leave links below to download all of the correct files needed. Android USB driver for Windows, Odin, your firmware. If you have the unlocked version of the Note 10 Plus, then the baseband will start with N975U1. The carrier version is N75US. Our carrier is with AT&T. But the T-Mobile firmware will work because they have the same baseband version. If you have Sprint, then use the Verizon file. Just make sure to have your desired carrier SIM in your phone when you install the firmware, and your phone will configure the correct one. Set up phone. Breeze through the welcome prompts to get to the home screen. Tap the arrow. Choose I have read and agreed to all of the above, and then next. Choose skip this for now, and then next. Choose skip, and then skip anyway. Choose next, more, accept. Choose not now, and skip anyway. Skip, skip, and now finish. Now let's turn on USB debugging mode and verify apps over USB. Just pull down the notification shade and tap on the gear icon to enter settings. Scroll all the way down and tap on About Phone. Tap Software Information. Find Build Number and tap on that section multiple times until you can get a prompt that developer mode is turned on. Go back twice and scroll down again. Tap on Developer Options. It should be turned on. Now find USB debugging mode and toggle that on. Choose OK. Scroll down to verify apps over USB and make sure that is toggled on. Go back to your home screen. Do not connect your phone to your PC until you install the latest version of Android USB driver for Windows. Click on Next, Next, Install, and then Finish. Connect your phone to your PC via USB Type-C cable. Allow your PC to have access to your data on your phone. The new Dex app will try to start running on your phone and PC. Just tap on the home screen button on your phone and exit out of the program on your PC. Set up PC. Let's extract the Odin and firmware files from the zip. Right-click on the Odin file, choose Extract All, and then Extract. A new window will open with the folder we created. Do the same thing to the firmware file. Because it's a larger file, let's focus back on our phone. Turn off the Note 10 by holding down the Bixby button and volume down button. Tap power off and then power off again. Once the phone has completely shut down, hold down the Bixby button, volume up, and volume down button all at once. Let go once you see the blue warning screen. Then press the volume up button to continue. You should now see a blue screen that says download. After your firmware is done extracting, close that window and go back to your download folder. It is very important to add the SIM of your desired carrier to your phone before installing the firmware. Doing so will ensure proper network configuration. Flash Odin. Go back to the download folder and enter the Odin folder. Right-click on the Odin program and select Run as Administration. Click Yes. You will know the phone has a proper connection with the Odin program because the ID COM will have a blue active COM. Also, the log tab will indicate that an ID has been added. Begin loading the firmware by clicking on the BL button. Locate the folder that has your firmware file and choose the file that starts with BL. Do the same thing with the AP button. Depending on how much processing power your PC has, this can take up to 20 minutes to load. It will even say that it's not responding, so please be patient. Once that has completed, do the same thing with the CP button. Once you get to CSC, choose CSC and not Home CSC. Do not load user data. Now that everything is loaded, you can hit the start button. It is very important that you do not disconnect your phone from your PC while Odin is installing the firmware. The installation process will vary. Mine took about 4 minutes. If you made it this far in the installation process, then it is time to give yourself a big pat on the back. This is not an easy process and you've come a long way. I am very, very proud of you, and you should be proud of yourself as well. Odin will now indicate that the installation has passed, and your phone will restart into recovery mode. Reboot system now should be highlighted, so just press the Bixby button to restart the phone again. This is another time where you will need to be patient while the phone and the SIM pull up the best network settings and bonus feature for your carrier. I was so happy that I was able to get all of the carrier apps on my husband's unlocked Note 10 Plus. He was able to get native visual voicemail and AT&T video call. That is so important for us to have working together because he is a truck driver. Restore your data. I connected the OTG adapter to the Note 10 Plus and the other end of the USB Type-C cable to the S10 Plus. I followed the prompts on the Samsung Smart Switch app, and everything transferred seamlessly. If you backed up your information on your PC, just run the Samsung Smart Switch program and choose to restore. If you come across any problems, just hit me up in the comments and I will do my best to help you. If there's anyone that needs this information, please send them my way. And don't forget to subscribe for more detailed tutorials like this in the future. In the meantime, Catwoman out.